far away from Europe, the summer of 1964 saw the Thuds go into action for the first time. Soon they were sporting new camouflage as they were deployed in larger numbers to bases in Thailand and South Vietnam. From those bases, they launched the campaigns that were to write their name into history. For the F-105, Vietnam was the right place at the right time. Even during their service life up to that time, there had been continued problems with reliability, and as recently as 1962, they had all been grounded. Though those problems had been ironed out, the plague of minor defects and a series of accidents had continued almost up to their first Vietnamese missions. But the Thuds in Vietnam were to earn a completely different reputation as reliable and durable aeroplanes. They also earned a fearsome reputation as weapons. The importance of the Thunderchief in Vietnam can be simply indicated. During the first 5 years of their involvement there, they flew an amazing 75% of all USAF attack missions. If the skies of Vietnam were full of bombs, it was because Thuds put them there. From March 1965, increasing numbers of airstrikes were made on North Vietnam. Predominantly directed at communications targets, the raids relied almost entirely on the F-105s. The planes would heave themselves into the air with their loads of bombs and head for a rendezvous with a tanker near the North Vietnam border. For with the level of external stores they were carrying, and the way that, increasingly, they had to fly flat out all the way across Vietnam rather than cruising to and from the target, their range had been cut considerably, and even with full tanks, the journeys didn't leave much to spare. Then they flew on into hostile airspace. At the beginning of the war, the North Vietnamese had only limited air defenses, and the earliest raids were relatively quiet. Soon, however, supplies of anti-aircraft artillery, surface-to-air missiles, and MiG fighters began to multiply, and the raids were flown into the teeth of the most intense air defense system ever tested in warfare. The Thuds pounded the enemy bridges and roads, truck parks and military bases, and the Vietnamese fought back ably with very formidable weapons. While the loss ratio on individual raids could not be considered critical, a process of slow attrition that was to halve their number had begun for the Thunderchiefs. Only 833 were built, and nearly 400 were to meet their end in Vietnam. Production of the 105s had been completed in December 1964. Only 78 of the B model had been built. The majority, 610, had been F-105Ds. The D had acquired an extended nose in accommodating updated all-weather navigation systems, and thus was externally markedly dissimilar to the B. The other 143 were the twin-seat F model. It had always been expected that there would be a twin-seat version of the plane, but two earlier twin-seat proposals had been dropped. The Fs were to provide the stock for the later development of the last 105, the G, the Wild Weasel. The workhorse of the bombing raids was the D. The single seaters abounded on the bases, where the work of war went on 24 hours a day.